Hello everyone, I Professor Bhavik Kumar M. Kataria welcomes you into the video series of Computer Networks. We are discussing unit number 2, Application Layer. In this unit, till today we have discussed principles of computer application. And today we are going to discuss web. Generally, it is known as a World Wide Web, WWW. And after that, next session or in our next video lesson, we will discuss HTTP, Hypertext Transfer Protocol. This Hypertext Transfer Protocol. So whatever we are discussing, this thing we are discussing with respect to application layer. So what we have discussed in terms of principles in our last session, so let's see what we have discussed. In this case, we have discussed client server architecture and peer to peer architecture. So what is the client server architecture? In this thing, whatever the end systems located at any network look like, it is our mobile network. This one is our mobile network. So whatever the devices are located at the end system, we have discussed the network edge and network core. So with respect to network edge and core, so whatever the edge, that is it means boundaries, these systems are known as end systems. So these are the clients, whatever, it should be a smartphone, it should be a laptop, get it? So this smartphone is a client. It will work as a client. And it is our server, which is located at enterprise network. This one is our enterprise network. So it is one more client from the home network. It is our home network. So here the client is connected with the wired link, whereas here there is a wireless link through the signals. Get it? So on that session we have discussed how client is going to communicate with the server. So that was the client server architecture. Get it? Here that is one more client from the same network. So if you are still remain to watch this video of principles of computer applications, so you can click here on I button at top right corner and you can watch that video of earlier session and come back here to understand with a very good explanation. That is the second example of peer-to-peer architecture. These are the peer. Whatever the clients we have discussed, that is known as a peer. Whenever clients are communicating with another client, so it is known as a peer. That is peer 1, it is peer 2, get it? So one peer is going to communicate with another peer. It means one device is communicating with the another device. or we can say that one end system is communicate with another end system. So this thing is known as a peer-to-peer architecture. Get it? Same thing here, one peer is going to communicate with another peer. Peer from the same network or different network. Here these are the peers of mobile network. Whereas here this peer is from the home network. Same thing here, one peer is from the home network, one peer is from the enterprise network. Get it? Here both the peers are from the enterprise network. Get it? So peer from the same network or a different network are communicating. This type of architecture is known as a peer-to-peer architecture. We have already discussed in our earlier session. So let's see next. Today's our session is web. So let's start without wasting a time about web. So what is actually web? So we can say that whenever we are surfing any website, so we are calling it as a web. That is a short form of website. Actually there is a website, but we are calling it as a web. Get it? So what is web? That is website. Get it? So in 1989 when I was born, so at that time, on that year, Tim Berners-Lee was a researcher, puts a vision for the web document. Get it? Generally, we are in the era of paper documents. Get it? So there is a paper based system, then there is a file based system, and there is a database system. So these are the generation of different time with respect to computer softwares and websites. So in 1989, Tim Berners-Lee put a vision with the web document. And after 1 year, 1990, there is a part of pages like HTML and URI HTTP first web page editor browser worldwideweb.app. So in 1990, there was first web page through the browser that was a web document, and in 1994, founded the World Wide Web Consortium, that is known as a W3C. W3 means 3 times W, World Wide Web, WWW. So World Wide Web Consortium, in short known as a W3C. Get it? So that is all about the history, but let's go next. What is actually World Wide Web? So that is a repository of information linked together from points all over the world. It means whenever we are accessing any information from anywhere from the world, so that is we are accessing this type of information by using World Wide Web. Look like we are searching any websites, like we are typing google.com. Get it? So it is directly goes to the server. Get it? This site one, suppose we are surfing like google.com. Get it? This client is surfing google.com. So whenever you will look to the URL, so before the google.com, there is you will found World write www.google.com. Get it? So generally we are writing directly in today's time, but whenever World Wide Web web page was found, so at that time they there was need to write www, then dot, then Google, then dot, and that com, because that was a typical type of web pages on that time. Get it? So whenever any client will put a request, like it is request number one, so it will go to the server of that particular URL. Like we will see in detail uniform resource locator. This entire thing is known as a URL, like www.google.com. So entire thing is known as URL. So whenever any client will type URL, so directly it will go to the website server, and from there server will responds with that particular file. Like client is typing google.com, then request go to the server, and then after server responding with the that particular URL, like client will be able to surf the google.com. Same thing, after getting the home page of google.com, client will search anything else. Like suppose client is writing what is computer network. Get it? Suppose client is searching what is computer network. So again it will that particular request goes to the server, and server responding with the number of files. Get it? So client will be able to access the files. Suppose client is getting few reference of website, like website link 1, link 2, and link 3. Whenever you will search into the browser, you will find multiple links, list of multiple links. So suppose one link is from the another website, like in one link Google is responding with the like IBM link of IBM. So whenever a client will click on that particular link, so directly that request goes to the another server of IBM. Get it? And again file will be responded to the client. Like whenever a client will click on that particular, suppose the link of home page, so server will respond the home page of IBM. Get it? So that is the architecture of World Wide Web, how World Wide Web is working. Hope you are able to understand. Let's see next. Look like first there was abcd.com, as per we have discussed with the example of Google. In place of here there is a abcd.com. So request will goes to the server of abcd.com. And from that file is going to be fetched from the disk. Server will fetch this file, that is a particular file, this file. Actually file is stored inside the disk or a database of server. So whenever any client is requesting any file, so server will fetch that file from the disk, access this file from the disk, and responded to the client. That is a response. Get it? It is a response as a TCP connection. We will discuss our transmission control protocol and UDP protocol in detail. Whenever we will learn the protocols of transport layer. Suppose a client is clicking, suppose there is a hyperlink inside, like we have discussed, like there is a link of IBM, IBM in Google's homepage. So let's see here, there is a one another link of xyz.com. So whenever client will click on this link, whenever client will click this link, so it is directly redirected to the server of that particular link. Like suppose there is a link is xyz.com. So directly it is redirect to xyz.com, and again that particular file will be fetched from the disk and responded to the client. Get it? That is the response connection. Get it? So whatever we are accessing, that is we are accessing from the internet. We have already discussed what is internet. That is a collection of different networks, like home network, mobile networks, enterprise network. Those are going to be connected with each other and made a internet. Get it? Like international, there is a internet. Internet means one network is going to communicate with another network. So you are understanding what is World Wide Web. So let's see what's happened into the client side step by step. So first, there is a browser determines the URL, seeing what was selected. Look like suppose person is writing xyz.com. So that is a URL. It is uniform resource locator. Is uniform resource locator. We will discuss this URL in detail in this session. So it will determine the URL by select the what was selected, like xyz.com URL selected. So browser determines what is going to be selected. Then browser ask DNS for the IP address. Like here there is example of www.itu.org. We have discussed with the google.com. Get it? So DNS is a domain name system. Get it? We will discuss in this unit, third or fourth lecture. It means DNS directly found the server. Get it? Directly the request goes to the server, like DNS reply, that is the IP address. IP address is with the naming system, like whenever your record is going to be stored, wherever you have taken the admissions, like any university. So university is generating enrollment number. Get it? So every time it is not possible to fetch the records with the name of student. Maybe there is students with the same name. So that's why the domain name systems arrives to identify the separate users, websites, and there is IP addresses. So we will also discuss IP address in details. Next, the browser makes a TCP connection to port 80. These are the port number. We will also discuss. It is one element in a URL. Get it? So somewhere, whenever there is a typical type of web pages, so port number is visible. Suppose you want to search the port number. So I will explain you how to find the port number whenever we will discuss URL. So just keep in mind, right now port number 80 is going to be used. There is a various type of different port numbers are used for the different purposes. Like in theater, we are using two doors. One is for the entry and one is for the exit. Get it? Whenever you will go to the cinema. So there is two doors. One is for the entry and one is for the exit. Get it? Same thing. In terms of computer network, various types of port numbers are there, which is used for the different services. Like same thing, whenever you will go to the bank, so there are multiple types of counters. One counter is for deposit, get it? Another counter is for the withdraw money, get it? Like some counter is for the loan, one first counter is for the reception. Get it? Same thing here, different port numbers are there into the network for different services. And then it sends over a request asking for file home.index.html. It means that is a first response. Client is asking. Get it? So whenever this request go to the server, so server will send that particular file. So it is a response of that particular request, and then the TCP connection is released and browser displays that particular page. Whenever the client will get a response, so directly client will be able to visible that particular file into their browser. Suppose you are making request from your Chrome browser, so whenever response is arrived, so you will able to look home page in your browser, and then browser fetches the displays all images in this file one by one. Right now there is a very high speed internet, so you are not getting one by one element is how elements are going to be fetched. But if there is a very slow speed before many years, so one by one images are going to be displaced, one by one images videos are going to be displaced, another elements are going to be displaced. So at that time there is a visible, get it? So this procedure is going to be in sequence. So that was everything what's happened into the client side, get it? So let's see next. If you will look about the browser, whenever you will type any URL from your browser, so these are the examples of various protocols are going to be used. Here there is a HTTP hypertext transfer protocol, that is FTP file transfer protocol. Here there is a telnet, that is terminal network, and one is SMTP simple mail transfer protocol. So these are the various type of protocols are used in towards the client browser that is connected with the controller. Controller are using different protocols, whereas browser will suppose browser is using the HTML hypertext transfer protocol. So whatever the URLs going to be fetched, so that is with respect to JavaScript, Java interpreters, this type of technology is going to be used. Like suppose there is a static web page, we will discuss the fundamentals of web page in next slide. So if there is a static web page, so there is maybe a HTML or CSS, get it? If there is a dynamic web page, so maybe there is a use of Node.js in current implementation. People are using Node.js for implementing a dynamic web page. So these are the technologies are going to be used. Now see what happens at a server side. So if you will look about the server side, so server accept a TCP connection from a client browser, and then get the name of file requested, then get the file from disk, like we have discussed in figure how file is going to be fetched from the disk. If you will look here, get it? So that is what happens in server side, file is going to be fetched, and then next return the file to the client and release the TCP connection, get it? So that is a phase we have discussed in transmission control protocol. There is a look like connection establishment, then after data transfer, and then after connection release, look like a circuit switching. So that thing is what's going to be happen at a server side. How web server is look like? So that is a multi-thread web server, that is a cache memory. We will also discuss the concept of cache. We have already discussed the concept of cache memory in operating system also, whenever we have discussed operating system. So cache is a one type of temporary storage. We have discussed cookies. At that time we will discuss cache in detail whenever we will discuss cookies. So cache is a temporary storage. Whenever web server is getting a request, so suppose data is available into the cache memory, so directly server will found the data from the cache and respond to the clients. Suppose data is not available in cache, then and then server will look data into the disk or a storage. Most of the data, whatever the web pages are frequently accessed, so that frequent data is going to be stored inside the cache memory by the help of cookies, get it? So I will explain you in detail types of cookies and how cookies are working. Now that is a client requesting objects through a web cache, get it? So it is work look like a proxy server. Whatever we have discussed cats. So actually that is a origin server. Get it? So whatever the request arrived from the client side, that is going to be forwarded to the origin server and it is the responded to the client. Get it? So whenever we are fetching the data from the proxy server, look like a web cache. Let's see how modern server side working in today's time. That is the result, the name of web page requested and authentic at the client. It is authentication and security right now. If you will, till today you are found the HTTPS. Get it? Hypertext transfer protocol with the securities. So perform access control on the client and then perform access control on the web page. Then check the cache. If data is found inside the cache, then fetch the requested. If data is not available into the cache, then it will fetch the data from the disk. Then determine the MIME. It is multi-purpose internet mail extension protocol. So type include in response, then take care of miscellaneous forwards and ends. So that is for the security. Return the reply to the client and make entry in the server log. So that is all about how modern server is working. Let's see next. That is URL, uniform resource locator. So what is the work of URL? So it is look like unique name. Whenever there is a need to identify the any web page, so URL is helpful for the identity. It is producing the identity of web page. Get it? In that case, these are the various element. First element is protocol. Get it? Look like whenever you are writing, whenever you will look the URL, so there is a HTTP or HTTPS. So that is a protocol. And then after the host, look like a google.com. So Google is a host. Get it? Like http://google.web.google.com. So that is a host, google.com. Somewhere there is a port number is also written, like somewhere look like a port number 8090, and then after path like any particular page. Get it? Look like somewhere there is a home page. Get it? Or there is a particular location of particular page. So it is a particular path of any pages. These are the port number. Like whenever you want to see whatever the protocols are going to be used, what are the port numbers, so you can try in your computer systems. Just go into command prompt by typing Windows R, type cmd, so you will find a one black screen in your system. And whenever you will write, type the ipconfig. So you will get the IP addresses. Whatever the servers you are going to be access, or any type of connections you are accessing. You go, suppose you are accessing any Wi-Fi connection, get it? Or any LAN connection. So whatever the network you will access, you will find the IP addresses of that particular network. Suppose you want to go in deep, you want to know the protocols are going to be used, host and port number. So you can type netstat, then after you have to put space, don't write underscore, that is space, and then you have to write dash a. So you will find the list of protocols are going to be used, or whatever the port numbers are going to be used in detail. Get it? So try it by yourself. Let's see next. Type of web document. There are two types of web document. One is a static web document. So there is use of HTML, hypertext markup language, extensible markup language, extensible style language, or extended HTML. Get it? So what happens into the static web documents, which is look like a login page. Whenever you are going to login any website, so what you will get into the login page? You will get there is a username. Get it? In that box you have to enter the usernames. Then is another box for the password. Get it? So in that case you will type a password, and then after there is a one button with the text login. Get it? Like one another button of cancel if you want to cancel the login. There is a button of forgot password. Get it? So these are the fix element. These are the fix elements. So there is no modification. Just you are writing username here, you are writing password here. So this entire structure is fix. So if there is a no modification in page, all elements are fixed inside the page. So in that case, we can call it that is a static web document or static web page. Get it? Next, let's see that is a request to the server for the static document. Next, we will discuss dynamic document and active document. So let me explain you what is dynamic document and what is active document. So if you will look about the dynamic web document, so there are two types. One is server side dynamic web page generation, and one is client side dynamic web page generation. So client side dynamic web page generation is known as a active document. What is difference between dynamic web page generation and client side dynamic web page generation? It means active document. So that is whenever changes are made on server side, so whatever the changes are going to be made, this change is happen here into the server side. So whatever the change is going to be made, the change is made to the server side. Here in terms of active document, directly this change are going to be made into the client's browser. Changes are going to be made on client's browser. So whenever there is elements of any web page is going to be changed, so that thing is we are calling it as a dynamic web page generation. Look like there is not a typical type of page, look like login page. So some of the elements are going to be changed or modified into the next pages whenever you will visit any website. So that is dynamic web page. But if you will look some specific website, look like you are finding a cricket score. Get it? So whenever look like multiple websites, look like a cricket info, and many websites are there which is updating the cricket score. So whenever you will access any page on that website, so what is there? Look like there is a scoreboard. So whenever there is a modification in scoreboard, like a wicket is fall down, or there is a new runs are arriving, so that is directly changes within a couple of seconds or couple of minutes. So there is no need to make a refresh. So that is known as an active document. But whenever there is a there is not an active document, so there is need to press refresh in that case. Get it? Whenever you will press refresh, then and then you will get the updated content in dynamic web page at a server side. Whereas whenever there is a dynamic web page in client side, so there is no need to put a refresh. Automatically page is going to be refreshed and you will get the contents. So that is the difference between dynamic web page generation at server side and dynamic web page generation at a client side. So that was everything about the www World Wide Web. If you have any query regarding to the today's session, so you can make me comment on comment box. In our next session, we will discuss HTTP Hypertext Transfer Protocol. So stay connected. Thank you very much.